Hey, what's going on, guys? So I just wanted to make a quick update video for you guys, letting you know that I actually have 3 tests this week. I don't know when this video is going to go up, either Monday or Tuesday, but I do have 3 tests this week, so this probably will be my only upload for the whole week. We'll see. Maybe I'll get one up Friday or Saturday. I don't know. Depends on how the rest of the week goes and how busy I am, but I just want to make this quick update video so there's not nothing all week. And I want to just talk to you guys a little bit about things that are changing on the channel that won't affect you guys at all. If anything, it's definitely beneficial to me, which is in turn beneficial to you guys, because it'll increase my productivity and my ability to produce videos. So the first thing that I want to bring up and mention is that I'm leaving my partner network. If you guys didn't know, I was partnered with Freedom from the moment that this channel came into existence, into creation. I've been with Freedom, and I've been with them the whole time. And I recently applied to Curse Union for Gamers, and they accepted my application. I meet their requirements. You need, I think, 1,000 subscribers and like 5,000 monthly views or something, which I have a lot more. I think I have like 7,000 or 8,000 monthly views, so it's all good. They accepted my application, so now I'm just waiting for the 30-day period to go up for being dropped from Freedom. So basically, what happens is you can request to be unlinked from your network. As long as you're not under contract, you can request to unlink from your network, and Freedom basically doesn't address the request at all. All they do is they just leave it there for 30 days, and after 30 days, YouTube automatically unlinks the channel with the network. So that's kind of what I'm waiting for. I'm maybe like a week in or something, so I still got like 3 weeks left under Freedom, and then I'll be switching over to Curse. And there's a couple of big reasons why I'm switching. I'm not going to knock Freedom at all. It's a great opportunity for people who are just starting their channels and need some place to go and need somewhere to network. They need a network so that way they can, you know, communicate with people and have some sort of backbone and assets to help them build their channel. But there are a couple of things that I don't like about them. One of the really big ones is they have their payments are very behind, and I know that that's not that big of a deal for me because I don't make a lot of money every month. It's almost nothing, so, you know, don't think that I'm actually like making money on YouTube. I'm not. It's really like a small amount, but they are very behind. They're months behind on payments, and, you know, if I'm gonna keep growing and I'm gonna keep getting bigger, I don't want to have to deal with that, you know, going forward. I don't want to have to deal with waiting like a super long time for revenue that should have come months ago. So I don't know what the problem is there, or if this is just how they do things, you know, where things are just delayed a few months. But it feels very unprofessional. It feels very sloppy, and, you know, I think it could be done better. So that's like the biggest reason why I'm switching. The other reason is I am getting a better revenue share with Curse for Gamers. I'm getting a way, way, way better revenue share with them, which means I'll be getting paid more per, you know, for views. So yeah, again, I don't really make much at all on YouTube, but going forward, this is going to help me a lot with, you know, just having more income and getting more for what I'm actually putting into my channel. And the last thing and the last reason that I'm switching is because the requirements for Curse are a lot higher. You know, you can be in Freedom with 0 subscribers. There's nothing that you need to be in Freedom, but you do need to have a certain level of fan base to be in Curse. And that means for me, if I'm in Curse, I know that the other people in that network also have a fan base that is around my size or bigger, and that allows me to network with people who could help me grow, and I can help them grow by doing collabs and shout outs and things along those lines. So it's just you know, it's just a network of people my size basically, or bigger. Obviously there's people that are like way bigger in Curse, but, you know, the entry level Curse requirements, there's probably a lot of people around my size in Curse, and that just makes it easier for me to network with them and kind of, you know, get you know, more people to interact with that are, you know, that don't have 25 subscribers, because a lot of people, you know, with only a few subscribers ask me for collabs and all this stuff, and like I can't do all of those, so you know, I have to pick people who are around my size, and Curse is going to help me find those people. And finally, I don't really think Freedom has done that much for me, and that's mainly my fault, and that's not a bash on them. I didn't use any of the things that they put on the table for me. I didn't use their forums, I didn't use any of the other stuff. I basically grew my channel organically. I grew it just through constantly putting out content, marketing it on Twitter and Instagram and pretty much everywhere that I could, Facebook, whatever. And because of that, I don't think any of the things that Freedom is offering me are really beneficial, because I'm obviously growing without their help, I guess. They might be doing things in the background, you know, with ads or whatever that are helping me that I don't know about. So again, this isn't knocking them, because, you know, this is something that I didn't take advantage of what they're offering, but what they're offering wasn't good enough for me to take advantage of, if that makes any sense. You know, I didn't feel like I needed what they were offering to grow, and then when I started growing, it was proven true. I didn't actually need the forums to promote my videos or whatever. So yeah, it just doesn't seem like there's anything worthwhile for me on Freedom at the moment anymore, so I'll be switching to Curse. Again, so that doesn't affect you guys at all. All that means is I'm going to be with a bigger, better network, in my opinion, and that's going to be better for my channel, my videos, my revenue, my everything. So yeah, it's overall just an improvement. And it's all thanks to you guys. If it weren't for me hitting 1,000 subs recently, I wouldn't have had this opportunity. So this is a huge step in the right direction, and I'm really, really glad that I can actually do this and partner with Curse. So thank you guys. The other thing that I want to mention, and this is actually something that showed up in my Q&A video, is that I do have an official apparel store now. You can find the link in the description below. It is through Spreadshirt. It's shop.spreadshirt.com/omniarch, and you can go there. There's just shirts for men and women, tank tops, hoodies, and a mug on there, all with like the super basic OmniArch logo design. So this is just, you know, a way if you guys want to grab a shirt. I know I posted it on Twitter as well, and some of you guys actually said the design was really sick, and they thought that it looked fresh and they wanted to get some stuff. So I figured I'd let you guys know officially in this video. The link is down below. If you guys want to get merchandise, it's fine. If you don't, you seriously don't have to. I really don't care. It's up to you guys. If you want to, the option is there. If you don't want to, that's fine. Don't click on it, don't check it out. I'm not offended, and honestly, I don't even make that much off of the shirts anyway, so you know, it's not like I'm saying this to money whore my way into a bigger bank account or whatever. It's just for those guys who enjoy my content and, you know, would like to support me by wearing my shirt. And, you know, maybe someone at school is gonna be like, oh, what does that even mean? What is OmniArch? What is that? And then you can, you know, help me grow. And that is all it's really about, you know, that I can't ask for anything more from you guys other than just share it with your friends, share my channel and my social media links with your friends. And a t-shirt is just a way to do that. You know, hopefully you guys like the design, and I like the fact that you guys can spread the word. So again, link is in the description. If you want to check it out, awesome. If not, that's totally fine. I don't hate you. In fact, I love you anyway for watching the video. Also, I wanted to leave a few things for you guys to talk about in the comment section below. So hopefully you guys, if you've made it this far, you are engaged with the video and you want to comment down below and help me out. I posted on Twitter asking if you guys wanted me to go multi-COD. Basically, all that means is that I'll be posting Call of Duty videos from various Call of Duties, Modern Warfare 2, Black Ops 2, Black Ops 1, etc. You know, I just figured, you know, if I don't have to play Black Ops 3 for every single gameplay, that would be cool for me, just because I can switch it up a little bit. But honestly, it doesn't matter. I don't care. If you guys want to see Black Ops 3, that's fine. Let me know in the comment section below, Black Ops 3 only. If you want to see multi-COD, again, comment down below saying, yes, I'd love to see Modern Warfare 2, Black Ops 2, Black Ops, whatever, Modern Warfare 3 even. Let me know in the comment section below if I should go multi-COD or not, and I will greatly appreciate that. Finally, the last thing I want to ask you guys is, if you're watching the GTA videos, what do you think of them? I know that they don't do as well on my channel as my Call of Duty videos, mainly because this is a Call of Duty channel, and I totally understand that, but there are a lot of you that did want me to expand into other games, and a lot of you seem to think that Grand Theft Auto was that option, was the best option. So I'm doing GTA because you guys asked for it, and I'm really, really, really enjoying the game. It's so much fun. So I just wanted to ask you guys what you think of those videos in the comment section below. Let me know what you think of the GTA videos and what I can do to improve them or whatever, and that will be greatly appreciated. Anyway, hopefully this wasn't too boring of a video. I just wanted to get this out again so that way there's not a week where I just don't upload because of my crazy test schedule. I just wanted to make this video really quick. Hopefully you guys enjoyed it, and hopefully you guys will continue to support me so I can keep bringing you these super awesome update videos filled with like amazing things that I did not think that I would hit so soon. So again, thank you guys for 1,000 subs. If you want to check the shits out, link in the description below. What do you think of Multicod? What do you think of my GTA videos? And thanks for watching. Make sure you leave a rating, like or dislike, whatever, and subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. That's a bit, guys. Thanks for watching. Omniarch out. Peace.